I am Ra. I greet you in the love and in the light of the one infinite creator. We communicate now. Question 86.1. Questioner, would you first please give me the condition of the instrument? Answer, I am Ra. The instrument's distortion towards physical energy complex deficit has slightly increased since the last asking. The vital energy levels have had significant calls upon them and are somewhat less than the last asking also. Question 86.2. Questioner, what was the nature of the significant calls upon the vital energy? Answer, I am Ra. There are those entities which entertain the thought distortion towards this entity that it shall remove for the other selves all distortions for the other self. This entity has recently been in close contact with a larger than normal number of entities with these thought complex distortions. This entity is of the distortion to provide whatever service is possible and is not consciously aware of the inroads made upon the vital energies. Question 86.3. Questioner, am I correct in assuming that you are speaking of incarnate third density entities that were creating the condition of the use of the vital energy? Answer, I am Ra. Yes. Question 86.4. Questioner, what is the present situation with our fifth density service to self-polarized companion? Answer, I am Ra. The period which you may call crisis remains. Question 86.5. Questioner, can you tell me anything of the nature of this crisis? Answer, I am Ra. The polarity of your companion is approaching the critical point at which the entity shall choose either to retreat for the nonce and leave any greetings to fourth density minions or lose polarity. The only other potential is that in some way this group might lose polarity, in which case your companion could continue its former greeting. Question 86.6. Questioner, in the last session you had mentioned the properties precipitating from the veiling of the mind, the first being envisioning or far-seeing. Would you explain the meaning of that? Answer, I am Ra. Your language is not overstrewn with non-emotional terms for the functional qualities of what is now termed unconscious mind. The nature of mind is something which we have requested that you ponder. However, it is, shall we say, clear enough to the casual observer that we may share some thoughts with you without infringing upon your free learned teaching experiences. The nature of the unconscious is of the nature of concept rather than word. Consequently, before the veiling, the use of the deeper mind was that of the use of unspoken concept. You may consider the emotive and connotative aspects of a melody. One could call out, in some stylized fashion, the terms for the notes of the melody. One could say, quarter note A, quarter note A, quarter note A, whole note F. This bears little resemblance to the beginning of the melody of one of your composer's most influential melodies, that known to you as a symbol of victory. This is the nature of the deeper mind. They are only stylized methods with which to discuss its functions. Thusly, our descriptions of this portion of the mind, as well as the same portions of body and spirit, were given terms such as far-seeing, indicating that the nature of penetration of the veiled portion of the mind may be likened unto the journey too rich and exotic to contemplate adequate describing thereof. Question 86.7. Questioner, you have stated that dreaming, if made available to the conscious mind, will aid greatly in polarization. Could you define dreaming or tell us what it is and how it aids polarization? Answer, I am Ra. Dreaming is an activity of communication through the veil of the unconscious mind and the conscious mind. The nature of this activity is wholly dependent upon the situation regarding the energy center blockages, activations, and crystallizations of a given mind, body, spirit complex. In one who is blocked at two of the three lower energy centers, dreaming will be of value in the polarization process, in that there will be a repetition of those portions of recent catalysts as well as deeper held blockages, thereby giving the waking mind clues as to the nature of these blockages and hints as to possible changes in perception which may lead to the unblocking. This type of dreaming or communication through the veiled portions of the mind occurs also with those mind, body, spirit complexes which are functioning with far less blockage and enjoying the green ray activation or higher activation at those times at which the mind, body, spirit complex experiences catalyst, momentarily blocking or baffling or otherwise distorting the flow of energy influx. Therefore, in all cases it is useful to a mind-body-spirit complex to ponder the content and emotive resonance of dreams. For those whose green ray energy centers have been activated, as well as for those whose green ray energy centers are offered an unusual unblockage due to extreme catalyst, such as what is termed the physical death of the self or one which is beloved occurring in what you may call your near future, dreaming takes on another activity. This is what may loosely be termed precognition or a knowing which is prior to that which shall occur in physical manifestation in your yellow ray third density space-time. This property of the mind depends upon its placement, to a great extent, in time-space, so that the terms of present and future and past have no meaning. This will, if made proper use of by the mind-body-spirit complex, enable this entity to enter more fully into the all-compassionate love of each and every circumstance, including those circumstances against which an entity may have a strong distortion towards what you may call unhappiness. As a mind-body-spirit complex consciously chooses the path of the adept and, with each energy balanced to a minimal degree, begins to open the indigo ray energy center, the so-called dreaming becomes the most efficient tool for polarization, for, if it is known by the adept that work may be done in consciousness while the so-called conscious mind rests, this adept may call upon those which guide it, those presences which surround it, and, most of all, the magical personality which is the higher self in space-time analog as it moves into the sleeping mode of consciousness. With these affirmations attended to, the activity of dreaming reaches that potential of learned teaching which is most helpful to increasing the distortions of the adept towards its chosen polarity. There are other possibilities of the dreaming not so closely aligned with the increase in polarity which we do not cover at this particular space-time. Question 86.8. Questioner, how is the dream designed or programmed? Is it done by the higher self, or who is responsible for this? Answer, I am Ra. In all cases the mind, body, spirit complex makes what use it can of the faculty of the dreaming. It, itself, is responsible for this activity. Question 86.9. Questioner, then you are saying that the subconscious is responsible for what I will call the design or scriptwriter for the dream. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is correct. Question 86.10. Questioner, is the memory that the individual has upon waking from the dream usually reasonably accurate? Is the dream easily remembered? Answer, I am Ra. You must realize that we are overgeneralizing in order to answer your queries, as there are several sorts of dreams. However, in general, it may be noted that it is only for a trained and disciplined observer to have reasonably good recall of the dreaming. This faculty may be learned by virtue of a discipline of the recording immediately upon awakening of each and every detail which can be recalled. This training sharpens one's ability to recall the dream. The most common perception of a mind, body, spirit complex of dreams is muddied, muddled, and quickly lost. Question 86.11. Questioner, in remembering dreams, then, you are saying that the individual can find specific clues to current energy center blockages and may, thereby, reduce or eliminate those blockages. Is this correct? Answer, I am Ra. This is so.